Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to an exciting 29 minutes, 33 seconds of yours truly, Robert Bobel, brought to you by Community Conversation and LCBC. It has been a beautiful, beautiful weekend. And we hope that this type of temperature, this type of just beauty, we have through the rest of the summer. Now, you know, the Italian festival is in town starting this, matter of fact, I think today. And we usually get rain for at least a week while the festival is in town. And, you know, it's always been me to say, you know, how we come at God and we worship his name and glorify him. And yes, God is a jealous God. We have to remember that. And when you have cigars smoking and drinking and in his name or because of him, and you bring communities together and they start to be merriful like that, I look at it in a different light. And so what he does is he rains on our parade because of our intentions or the intent of what we're doing. So, you know, this for several years, and I mean, as I can remember, when this type of carnival or this type of gathering comes to town, he will shed some rain, meaning he shed light in a different facet so we can get a better idea and a respect for God himself. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to say yesterday I have twin daughters, Krishan and Alicia, and of course Alicia was so frustrated with school, she finished it a year early. Krishan, she graduated yesterday at the Bob Carpenter Center and from AI DuPont, and she's on her way to Alabama, and I'm just so, so proud of my children. You know, they have really, really buckled down and took, you know, a serious hook on life. And, you know, one thing I want to say to my parents out there is we have to lead by example. And, you know, when they see that they have parents who work hard and come from good work ethic, children learn to apply that to their adulthood or as they form into an adult. And then they start to share those experiences with their friends and they start to apply those experiences to their growing pains and growing patterns in life. And that is so, so wonderful. So I want to say thank you, great job, and Daddy's looking forward to flying to Alabama, and when you graduate from Alabama, and when your sister graduates from the college of her choice, and your brother graduates from the college of his choice, we'll be right there to support you. Also wanted to say, listen, you know, I always like to talk about, you know, my lady does hair, and she does a great job with hair for 26 years, and over there at Sacred Heart, 691-7800, Deneen Tickles, awesome, fascinating job with the seniors and with people. And if you want somebody that's going to take their time out to understand, you know, what your problem is, whether it's through sickness or medication, your hair won't grow, you want it to grow, and how can you, you know, get extensions, or if you want to put something in to accommodate what you want to do for the evening or for a certain organization or promotional event, she's right there to sit down with you one-on-one. And, you know, 691-7800 right there at Sacred Heart in the lower level. Deneen Tickles does an awesome job, baby. Thank you for taking care of the seniors. And anytime that Mr. Bovell's companies extend a courtesy to the seniors, she sets aside time and really, really works with them. So if you want to get your hair taken care of, if you're looking for a stylist, someone who will work with you one-on-one, you know, 691-7800 or 302-753-1064. You know, get in touch with her, leave her a message. She will call you back and assist you with those needs. One thing I want to also say that took place at the Bob Carpenter, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to take place. I'm sorry, not took place yet, but it's going to take place. There is supposed to be a summer R&B soul concert at the Bob Carpenter Center, and this is going to be next weekend, June the 13th, at Bob Carpenter Center. Doors open at 7 or 7:30, and the show starts promptly at 8:30. Sponsored by Duffy's Hope and One Vision and Live and Direct. This concert, you know, the reason why I mentioned it is there's some nice music in our air. Jacket Edge and Raheem Devon and Christy Michelli. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, it's a little chilly. I don't know why it's so cold here, but it's chilly in here. These people are going to be here at the Bob Carpenter Center. And I don't normally do the ticket prices because you can get a ticket at the Bob box office, but I think I need to let my viewers know how much a ticket costs because it's too late to save up for it. This is money you're going to have you know, at your leisure. The VIP tickets are $100. I don't know what the VIP consists of, but I'm pretty sure you can give them a call, and I will give you the phone number. And then you got $73, $67, $55, and $42. And anybody that wants to know about the show, because there is no phone number here on the flyer, but I think you can contact the Bob Carpenter Center. Yes, there is. There's an 800 number here. I'm sorry. 1-800-221-8421. That's 1-800-221-8421. Another thing, too, I want to say to Lappa. Lappa, we need a teleprompt machine to get fixed here in the studio. This has been like the third week, and they can't put our phone numbers up. They can't even put the name of our shows up. So we want to extend that to Lappa, who makes sure that they take care of their producers. But we do need you to get the teleprompt machine fixed or get them whatever they need, because we cannot extend phone numbers, emails, prices, anything, and or extensions of different holidays and so forth. And I believe the producers do deserve that respect. So I'm saying that to Lappa live here on 28. Please get the telecom machine fixed. I don't know if other producers are saying something, but Community Conversation is going to say something. Also, I want to let you ladies and gentlemen know the Russell Delegation. You know, I always followed them for years, and especially as a youngin. Russell Delegation has went through so many different transitions, but now, you know, they have actually a CD out that you can get online, and you probably can go to Amazon.com to get it. But they are a singing organization, and some people could say they're a singing church, because when you say church, you really just talk about your church only. But when you say organization, they do not mind traveling throughout the state or around the states and or outside the states, maybe in the countries, to deliver God's word. And I mean, they are a singing machine. We're looking forward, and I'm saying this live because I know the Smiths, one of them is actually a part of Russell Delegation, especially the men's choir. We want to reach out to them for Hilltop Day this year, which is August the 23rd from 1 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. right at the Judy Johnson Park, 3rd and Clayton. It's the safest day, ladies and gentlemen, and everything is free. My co-sponsor, Calvin Brown from New Life Christian Church, is always there to aid and assist. His church does a fascinating and a phenomenal job in aiding the community and making sure the food gets out, making sure they are attentive to all, from the children all the way to the seniors' needs in doing so. And that when we apply the security and the Wilmington Police and the Fire Department for safety and emergency response, and then even a couple of outside organizations, some of the men that work for me, we make sure that our children, our seniors, and the young people out there are having a ball and everything is safe. And I want to give kudos to the community, and especially some of the young people in the community where we look down on or say they always doing something negative. That is one day that those young men and women do participate and they embrace that community to give back to that community. And that's what I love about the Hilltop. You know, right now we can't get everybody out there to get behind the voting machines, but you know what? You're voting in spirit, and that's what I can appreciate. So look forward to see us again at Hilltop Day, our 14th annual. And Mr. Bovell hasn't come up with, you know, our theme is giving back and a throwback in time. We're gonna give back and a throwback in time. So look for all the music from the 70s and 80s and 90s, and we're gonna have a good time and look for a lot of entertainment. The flyers be out soon. Before I take a slight commercial break, I want to tell you all about a young man, and he's, you know, he's been different facets and ups and downs and balances in life. But one thing he's never give up on is the challenge to maintain, sustain, and or give back in his own way, not only to himself, but into his community and surrounding communities. Now, you know, one thing I can say about the gentleman, every Thanksgiving, and I mean, this has been for the last maybe 15 years, every Thanksgiving, because his devotion and his respect to myself and what I do and believe in, and we kind of latched on a long time ago, he's always made me a plate for Thanksgiving. And he don't care where I go in this country for Thanksgiving, when I come back, I know I got a plate, and the food is phenomenal. I mean, his potato salad and his seasonings and the things that he do, he's not one who caters to pork, so you can't look for ham, but you can best believe it's gonna be some smoked turkey or something in there to add to his own blend of seasonings and herbs. And some of us have gotten a chance to taste his food. So I'm gonna be bringing him on in this, we're gonna take a 30-second commercial break, I'm going to bring him on and tell you about a couple more things, reiterate about Hilltop Day that's coming up and some summer programs or summer jobs for our youth. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you in 22 seconds. Welcome back to yours truly, Robert Bovell, with Community Conversation, brought to you by Bovell Bell Bonds and LCBC. Ladies and gentlemen, again, I told you at the beginning of the show, it is a beautiful, beautiful day in there. Please, I know my seniors and my young people and a lot of people say, oh, they look forward to the show every other week and 11:30 to 12. And sometimes we have extended time at the courtesy of the Congos and Lapa. Especially the Congo's extra hours. They always say, Mr. Bovell, you know, go ahead and extend, or, you know, you want take another hour, it's on us. So I can say that about the Congo family. I appreciate that from Kim and Trippy and Sherry and Sammy. We thank you for that from Community Conversation. Chef Tyrone, I was telling you about him. You know, sometimes you get lost for words when it comes to certain individuals and their behaviors and their change in behaviors. But when they try to set out to do right, sometimes it takes, you know, the encouragement and the support and the backing of people like us to keep them focused and on that path. One thing about Tyrone, he understands his own struggles, and that's what a lot of our viewers and young people have to understand. When you recognize your own struggles, you have to take the time to embrace yourself. And as long as you stay on the straight and narrow, others will notice that change and then help you maintain that behavior. See, the only difference in doing right and wrong is understanding that you've done wrong and you want to do right. And that's what I can say about this young man we call now Chef Tyrone. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to to my immediate right, Chef Tyrone. I'm going to shake his hand, Ty. Thanks for coming out. You even went out and bought his little gear. His hat says Chef Tyrone. And, you know, Ty's been cooking all his life. And, you know, one time I had an opportunity to meet him when he used to be at Gander Hill, and they had him in the kitchen. And, you know, sometimes when, you know, they want to stretch something or add something to it, you know, what he probably seen his mother and grandmother do, and what some of the cooks that worked in the prison, you know, a lot of them wasn't really cooks. They just have to really understand to handle a certain amount of number of men with knives and stuff like that. And that's one thing that he did while he was there, say, listen, you know, we got to make sure we secure certain night because we're still in the prison. But, you know, we got to make sure we get the right ingredients in here so the people can have something to eat or not just waste. And that's what it is. And Ty, man, you've been cooking for about how long now?
About 20-some years.
20-some years. Yeah. And Chef Tyrone, where did the name come from? That's just something you thought about, or because you've been doing it for a while?
My fiance, Denise Spanish, gave me that name.
Oh, did she?
Yeah, she said I deserved it. So thank you, babe. But anyway, I want to thank God for another beautiful day that he allowed us.
Uh-huh.
I start off with that anyway. And I also want to congratulate everybody that graduated this year. And I don't care from kindergarten, the first grade, or whatever.
That's right.
You know what I mean?
We got to keep our kids focused.
Yeah.
Amen.
And we have to keep supporting them. You know what I mean? I don't care if they graduate from a B to an A.
That's right.
You know what I mean? It means a lot. It's the little things in life. It's not the big things in life. Anyway, I want to just say that I'm not going to take too much of your time, but I appreciate this opportunity to put Chef Tyrone's business out there. and do it the right way. And I want to thank a couple of people that supports me, like you, Norman Oliver, White Davis. He has a body shop. He buys pretty regular from me.
White's Body Shop.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
And I just want to just thank it. And all the other people that's been supporting me. And I also want to let everybody know that I'm getting ready to, this week. I'm going to cut a check out to one of the homeless shelters. I haven't figured out which one that needs it the most. But each meal that I sell, $1 goes to the homeless shelter.
Okay. You also got something for the seniors too, right?
Yeah. They all get 20% off.
Seniors get 20% off?
Yeah.
And your platters range from what price?
From $10 to $14.
$10 to $14.
And we have every day. I don't take days off because God don't take days off. I do this every day.
All right.
This is a daily lunch and dinner platter. Chicken, salmon, patties, fish, tilapia. Then we have the combination. We have a crab cake. We have fried or baked. We have jumbo shrimp fried or baked. I added pepper steak and rice, baked turkey wing stuffing and rice. And each meal, well, the seafood combo, it comes with two main courses of the crab cakes or the tilapia or the shrimp. Then you also get two sides, plus I give you ear corn with that. And each meal, each platter that I give out, I give a piece of cake, a roll, and a bottle of water.
Okay.
Yeah. And the whole thing about me cooking is I'm going to give back. God has been so good.
And you love cooking, though.
I love cooking. That's another thing. And it's,
you love cooking. It's the hardest, I think you found your niche.
Yeah, and it's the hardest job I've ever had. Oh, okay. I worked at General Motors, I've done an asbestos, and I've lost 30 pounds.
Okay.
And I've
that's just sweating in the kitchen.
Yeah, sweating and walking and just going here, going there, just
that
moving.
Might be a new exercise video, sweating in the kitchen.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? See, Denise ain't got to do that because you spoiled her.
No, yes, she just lays back but she's my partner. She's my partner with, you know,
and your part. Inspiration.
Yeah, very much, very
that's
much.
Very good,
I don't know where I would be, and I really mean this, if she wasn't in my corner.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
That's what you need.
Yes, that's Denise Madness is my fiance, and we're going to tie this knot December the 26th. Hopefully, things work all right, and God's will, because I'm ready for it. I want to get married.
I'm going to
marry
her.
You know what I mean? In Hawaii.
Okay.
Yeah. So she deserves it.
You gonna cook that day?
No.
That's your day.
That's my day. That's my day. But anyway, I just want to thank her because she takes care of all the little things that people don't know that goes behind, like the wrapping and all that, cutting the cake and keeping everything. But anyway, I just want to let everybody know that I think that I'm not the best, but I think I'm one of the best.
Man,
okay.
Your food tastes very good.
Yeah.
I mean, I had the liberty of tasting it. And I appreciate what you do for me every Thanksgiving.
And Christmas.
And Christmas too. I forgot to say that.
And out the 15 years I've been doing this, and I'm going to keep it real with you. I call him. I let him know the night before, which I never know where you're going to be.
I know. You're right.
And out the 15 years, it could have been longer than that. I've caught up with him about 8.
Yeah, that is true.
But the thing about it, I still make it, because I know how you're particular about, like, the next day, he can forget it. If you don't eat it, if you don't get it that day, he's not, you know. So I just chalk it off for.
Oh, okay.
You know, yeah, but I always have it put to the side because the things that you do and you're so busy in that time at that time of year or the time of the day, that you don't really, to me, I don't feel as though that you have the time to really eat a home-cooked meal because you're doing so much on Christmas.
Yeah, but, you know, I'm learning to put everything in perspective and, you know, how important family is. And, you know, I, too, like yourself, you know, is looking down the path of marriage.
Yes.
Denise, she's a beautiful sister.
And if I talk to you.
And September looks like a great date for us.
Well, that's you my birthday. Yeah, and I talked to you the other day about, I said, you know, because I've been around you long enough, and I can tell when you're happy, when you're not happy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you know what I mean? And so
she makes me happy.
Yes. And I'm happy for you.
Thank you, sir. And you know what, Ty?
Yes.
I wanted to say this, too, because there was an experience with the senior citizens over there where she does hair, and not to put another business on blast, but the seniors like to have something different. And in the preparation of having something different, you know, they don't get a chance too much to eat outside their normal behavior of eating.
I would love to.
So there was an establishment that they wanted fish sandwiches on Friday.
Wow.
And they had gave their money up for 28 fish sandwiches. And do you know the people brought their money back said, we don't have, we can't make 28 fish sandwiches. And they didn't get their fish sandwiches. And I'm hoping and praying they got their money back, but they didn't get their fish sandwiches. And you know, sometimes our seniors really look forward to something. So, you know, make sure I'll get a couple of your flyers. We'll send them over there to Sacred Heart, and maybe the seniors will give you a shout out. It's a Friday. They usually pick the Friday right after they get their checks and stuff like that. And they just want something different. You may, on the corner on the cob, you may have to take it off the cob. Yeah. You know, we're dealing with dentures.
Well, I can do that.
Yeah, shave it off or just give them some
corn. A couple people was asking me already. I thought they was kidding. But and they had their teeth.
Right.
And they just told me that they like it.
Well, you can say corn on the cob and corn off the cob.
Yeah.
You're going to get the same flavor.
Yeah, you're going to get
the same. But it's something about biting into that cob. Then you get
the thing
in there.
Yeah,
and the juices. I mean, it's good that way.
And then I season the corn, like, inside.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you have, like, your taste like a little cinnamon, like, in your corn.
All right, don't tell them your secret.
You
say, I season it.
I season it.
Now you're going to have everybody put, please don't put no cinnamon in my corn.
I never had that.
Let me do that.
Yeah. But anyway, you know, I would love to do that. If when it comes to kids and elderly, I'll be right there.
Yeah, you are.
I'll be right there. That's really my passion. I have the patience for that, and I would love to be a part of that. And it's time for us to show them that we still care for them.
Mm-hmm.
And time is, that's why you need. They just want some time, and it goes a long way. I feel so good when I can go over and bring my dad his platter and look at his face. You know. What I mean?
Yeah, yeah. I told you I stopped by a couple times.
Yeah.
He sits in his chair. Yeah. And and your brother Leon, he's comical because he's waiting for you to finish too.
Oh yeah.
But he can cook.
Yeah, yes, Leon can cook.
He can cook.
My grandma.
But because he cooks for your dad all the time.
Yes, yes, yes.
But. Them holidays, he turns the kitchen over to you, so he's like your dad. They waiting.
Yeah, yeah.
So
yeah.
I mean, he comes from a cooking instrument of individuals.
I try to give Leon a couple of days off during the week if I can.
Yeah.
And
I'm a hat off to him too. He does an excellent job with his dad.
Yes.
He's there plus working down Salvation Army, and you know I can appreciate any child or any adult that puts their life not on hold but on reserve, because he has a love for kids and working in the. You know, the nonprofit phase of working like he does, but they slow their life down to make sure their parents, this is called the circle of life, ladies and gentlemen, that their parents are cared for in a proper way. You know, so many of us, and you know, I don't understand, you know, I don't know particularly people's struggle or strain, but when we surrender our parents to nursing homes or to private industries, you know, we really take away from the true meaning of circle of life. You got to remember, when you were born, these same individuals fed you, bathed you, changed your diapers, no matter if you did one or two in a diaper, made sure you had a safe haven over your head, made sure you had a meal. Sometimes, you know, with the struggles, and you know, in the early 70s and 60s, there were struggles back then. With the struggles, you know, you may had one or a breakfast and a dinner or a lunch and dinner, whatever the case may be, but they still provided for us. And, you know, those were the things that, you know, I embraced. And believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Bovell, when, you know, my parents were here and God blessed their soul, I was there for my parents. And I had to slow myself down and I took my mom in or made sure my mother was okay. And before I drove home, whether living in Pennsylvania or living in Delaware, before I drove home, I would go get my mother her meal of her choice and,
Father
you know, and talk to her, read to her. If I had to, you know, wash her wounds and rewrap them, I did that. Same thing with my dad. You know, me and my dad didn't have the best relationship, but, you know, it was still my father. And no matter, you know, how upset or whatever, you know, angered him when it came to me, when it was time to take him in, I took him in.
Yes, you did.
And I made sure he had the right thing. And people can vouch for that.
Yeah,
you know, don't ever be too busy not to be there for that part of your life that's giving you life. And that's important. And that's the spirit of the young man that's next to me. And the reason why I said that and I extended that, he loves his dad. And I've watched, you know, Mr. Robinson, you know, he'll get on tie and snap on tie. And you would think some people would just walk away. That made him embrace his dad even more because those are called values. What he was instilling on him, his dad loved him from birth, and he just wanted him to do right or get it right. And once he does that, he extends more to him. And I think this is Ty's niche, chefing, cooking. He loves it. You know, there's, you know, some people call the kitchen the enemy because they don't want to do the cleanup part, or you hire somebody for that. But he cleans as he goes, and he also cooks in a clean environment. He won't cook like that. That's all. Since I've known him, he's been that way. So I'm extending to them, and you know, I'm going to talk to my staff, and everybody hasn't had a chance to enjoy it, but we're going to get something for the staff, and we're going to call you one day and surprise you.
Well, you know, I'm skimming. Can you, you know, I know it's going to come.
It's going to come. Yeah, it's going to come. When I get them all to taste it.
Yeah. But I also want to, this my number is, you can call me.
Give me your number.
Yeah, my number is 302-377-7787.
Say it again.
377-7787.
And that's 302.
302.
Yeah. Now, what time do they have to call for lunch? How much time do you need
I get up about like 7 in the morning and start doing my preparation.
So you prepping. Okay, yeah, good.
So you can call me between 8, 9 or whatever.
So all they got to do is say, listen, I need 4 dinners over here there at this time, by 12.
I appreciate that. It gives me, so I can
now put time. Now, I'm going to say this, because I know you just say Chef Tyrone. Suppose you get 3 or 4 orders, 3 or 4 different locations at the same time. Well, how do you do that?
Well, this is what I have.
You have help.
Well, no, I don't have help.
Oh, okay.
The only help I have is Denise when she's home.
Okay.
But what I do is I try to explain to them that I have 3 orders. I have to go here. 4 orders. I have to go here. And then somebody allows me to give me lead.
Great.
But you have to be honest, because people, when they on their lunch break, they only have so much time to eat.
That's why I said that.
And you have to be prompt.
Okay.
So what I try to do is come early, a little early.
I like that, man. See the honesty
early,
right there.
A little early, but it's all about honesty, you know, because then you can, you know, because once you mess up one time in this business, that company there.
Or them individuals.
You're done.
That's done.
You're done.
All right, now, so if you miss lunch, calling for dinner.
Yeah.
Now, that time, you got some time between dinner. And then if you tell me what time you need it, by that time is his lady's home, and she can probably go one direction, go the next direction. That's good. Listen, I know we only got about 60 seconds left, Ty. I'm going to give you 30 seconds to tell them right there in that camera about Chef Tyrone, the menu, and the phone number again. Right.
Okay. I'm Chef Tyrone. I'm pretty sure everybody's seen me somewhere. And now this is what I'm going to do, and this is what's keeping me on the straight way and the straight path, and I feel good about it. And I'm gonna make other people feel the same way I feel, that you can that you can do it if you want to do it, and believe in yourself. Don't never give up on yourself, because once you give up on yourself, it's over. Always remember this.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna let you finish. Those who hate.
That's right.
Those who hate.
Oh, I like that saying too. Yep.
Always remember that. Those who hate only win.
That's right.
When you hate them back.
That's right.
And only then, that's when you lose it.
That's right.
Destroy
yourself. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for tuning in from 11:30 to 12. I had a good time here. I put a lot of stuff out there. The Dale got some fascinating shows coming up on July 10th and the 17th. Please go to The Dale online, The Dale, www.thedale.com. In Philadelphia, it's some great OJs and Will Downing, great shows. Don't forget the Bob Carpenter Center next Friday. Don't forget to tune in 2 weeks with yours truly, Robert Bovell from Community Conversation, brought to you by Bovell Bell Bonds and LCBC. Hilltop Day, August 23rd from 1 to 7:30 p.m. Everything is free, ladies and gentlemen. Mad Security, we're going to have a great time, and I'm going to surprise you in the weeks to come. What we're going to do, we had the tunnel on Monday the last time, but we're thinking about something bigger. We'd love you here in Community Conversation. See you in 2.